Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. In my last video, I showed you how you can create an electronic copy of your handwritten signature and then use it on PDFs, Word files, Excel files, on your letters, contracts, invoices, etc. and also how you can set it up on Outlook as your signature. You know the bit where you mention your name and phone number? We used a website called remove.bg to get rid of the background of our signature, which in our case was the paper I wrote it on. As I said in that video, to make it transparent, Photoshop is your best bet. But since not many of us are Photoshop wizards, we used a website. So let's see how can we do the same job in Photoshop. You may not be comfortable sending your signature online to some website, and you might not know much about Photoshop. Either ways, if you have it, or maybe your colleague or a friend does, you don't need much of Photoshop expertise to do this. I'll keep it precise and avoid any detailed feature explanation so you can understand and repeat the steps easily. Let's begin. I have my original image opened up in Photoshop. As you can see, I have used a paper which already had some writing on it, so we need to get rid of that. But first, let's get this picture in the right orientation. We go to Image, Image Rotation, and we want our image to be rotated left and 90 degrees is perfect. So we select 90 degree counterclockwise and that does it. Before we start with any more modifications, let's get rid of this lock symbol from here. Now we need to get rid of the other things on our photo, this arrow symbol here, some practice runs over here and this bit up here. Press C on your keyboard for crop and now let's crop away by dragging the corners like this. The goal is to get rid of as much of the unwanted space as we can. But don't worry, as far as you can just get the signature in here, you're fine. Once you're satisfied with the crop, press enter or click on the check sign up top. Here we have our signature barring everything else. If you wish to move it, press and hold space bar on your keyboard so you see this hand symbol instead of the mouse arrow, and then using your mouse, you can move this image around so it better suits you. The next step involves removing the background, and since there are just two colors in this image, the color of the paper, which should have been white but is now more off-white, and the color of the signature. The easiest way to do it will be if we can select either of the two colors and then get rid of the off-white paper color. To avoid any confusion, let's select the color of the signature, because that's what we want to keep. To do that, go to Select, Color Range. You get this dialog box with a black and white version of your image. If you notice, your mouse arrow is now an eyedropper. That is to select the color. We need to take this on our signature and click on just the signature and not the paper. If the image is too small for you, press and hold Alt on your keyboard and with the help of your mouse wheel, you can zoom in and out. That's better. Now take the eyedropper and click on the signature. After you've clicked once, just to make sure that we get all the light and dark parts of our signature too, click on this icon here, the eyedropper with the plus symbol. This will add to your current selection. And now click on dark and lighter parts too. Once you get the whole thing here, get back to this box and check this option, fuzziness. If you drag this all the way to the right, it will select a lot more parts, and if you drag it all the way to the left, the selection of your signature will be choppy at best. In our case, we want it somewhere here. Hit OK and now just your signature is selected. We just have to get rid of the paper now that we have our signature selected. Do that, look for the mask option here at the bottom of the layers panel and click on it. Here we have our signature with no background. We still have some areas which are not required and we will use another tool to fix this time since we have transparent areas. Go to Image, Trim, and in here, make sure Transparent Pixels is selected and all these options are checked. What this will do is remove all the transparent pixels from all the sides. Hit OK and done. Now to save it, go to File, Export, Quick Export as PNG. And make sure you save it as a PNG file since PNG supports transparency. If you save it as a JPEG, your signature will have a white background. Not the dark white background as we did earlier, but pure white. Once you save it as PNG, you can start signing your contracts, letters and invoices and whatnots. So now, if you have Photoshop but haven't used it for this, you know how to. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, keep sharing, liking and commenting on this video. And if you haven't already, subscribe. Happy spreadsheeting.